Hi everyone and welcome back to Bloodborne. Now what is this? This is the Forsaken Castle Kanehurst, which is an optional area. And this character here is using the Blade of Mercy. Yeah, look at that awesome sword. It does have an S scaling in skill. I think, yeah, on plus 7. No, on plus 8 you will get the S scaling on skill. For now it's an A scaling, but that's nonetheless pretty awesome. And yeah, so the first area here, I really like to avoid most, if not all, enemies if I can, because they are really a pain. And yeah, I don't need them, I don't need to kill them, I mean. And yeah, I just want to get in here as soon as I can and not worry about these guys, because in here we do have enough to worry about. Believe me, that it is true. So there are ghosts in this area. The good thing is you can hit them with your normal sword. You don't need a special thing, a special sword or a special item like in Dark Souls 1. But yeah, it's just, there we go, there is one ghost. And they do hit pretty hard, believe me that. So yeah, ow, that was a little bit of a fail there. We did get the item, ooh, that's right, there's a chest down here. Let's hope we can open that and get away with it. So yeah, why are we going through this area? Actually, we need a weapon. Well, the Rite of Palash here is a very cool weapon as well, but it's not the one that I have in mind for this build. It is, however, another themed build, so that's why I'm wearing this attire here. So I don't spoil anything. I really don't want to get away anything, so yeah, I won't show you the character's name and stuff like that, because that would give it away. And yeah, now it is a skill build, and it is a build that I was eager to do for quite a time. So yeah, let's see if we can grab everything. There is, however, another item down here, another chest. Most of the time you will be able to grab it, but sometimes the animation doesn't. Whoa, the noble dress, best worn with for female characters. It does really look awesome on female characters. Yeah, on the male ones, not so good. But oh well. Okay, so here we have the first little challenge. You can go the way down there, or you can come up here, and we meet some new enemies here. And these guys, they do hit pretty hard. And they can take quite some hits, so do not underestimate these guys. Backstab them whenever possible, and you should be fine. So these guys do have a chance to drop bloodstone chunks. So yeah, keep that in mind. As far as I know, it is not the best place to farm for bloodstone chunks, because the drop rate is quite low, but I don't know, man. Sometimes I do a little run here, and it's enough for me anyways. With the rune equipped for more discovery. Yeah, it went pretty well last time, so I consider this as my point for chunk farming anyways. And yeah, to purchase the weapon, we will have to join the covenant that you can enter here. And we need, I think, 40,000 blood echoes, if I'm not too mistaken, to actually buy the weapon. So it is an expensive one, but it's the only weapon in the whole game that fits the character I'm building here. So yeah, I will have to go for it. But I wanted to show you this area as well, because I didn't include it in my main playthrough, because I didn't get here. I did, however, go through this area with the strength build Kenpachi that I showed off last time. And oh no, I really want to get a backstab here. Oh shoot! Yeah, that enemy does tremendous amounts of damage, so be very, very careful. Sometimes it can really mess you up. The combos as well. Yeah, nothing to really take on the easy side. Okay, but we shall continue. Let's see what is up next. I think more of those guys that we fought earlier. If we go out there, we can grab, I think, another chunk, but we will get ambushed. Which is okay for now, I think. And let's use the double side sword or the double swords here just to show them off. Quick attacks, not that heavy hitting attacks, but that's kind of what you expect from skilled weapons, right? So yeah, you have to make the best out of it and try to separate these two guys from each other because, ow, if they group up on you, you are pretty much dead. That's just how it goes. At least that's how I think it goes. Oh no, and that's exactly the attack that you want to avoid because it will probably kill me, to be honest. Thank goodness it didn't. But I really have to heal up here, and then we can engage again. The Blade of Mercy over here is a weapon that you can buy in the shop as soon as you finish a certain side quest, and this is where you get. Oh, the Executioner stuff. That's okay. That's the set that we used on Kenpachi, and I really like that set. I think it went really well together with the strength build. And yeah, we unlocked the shortcut here back to the lamp. So if we should die, whoops, this is basically our fast way up again. So this room is kind of interesting. You do have all those ghosts around you, and if you outmaneuver them correctly, which I hope I'm able to do, ouch, you can get to this chest without getting into too big of traps. To get the Evelyn here, which is the gun that does make the most damage out of the guns. So, oh wow, if you want to build a character based on Blood Tinge and make damage with your firearm, the Evelyn is probably your weapon to go. And yeah, those dark guys here, I like to take them out and leave the ghosts alone. Yeah. They are a pain, those dark guys. They will hit you and hit you and hit you. And I think up there is another one, but you do have these other enemies in here, so you have to be very, very careful what you're doing. Or else you will get surrounded and slaughtered. It happened to me quite sometimes, believe me. I know sometimes areas that I say are pretty harsh, don't look that way sometimes, but that's just because I've practiced the run-throughs multiple times just to make sure I can get through them. I will certainly die in those areas as well, even though I do know how they work. It's just, it's Bloodborne, don't forget that. Sorry, words, don't forget that, guys. It's still Bloodborne. It is still a very, very hard game. So yeah, those stuff is just normal to happen. And we do get some more of those guys in here. They really like to attack in groups though, which. No! I really need the backstab! The backstab! No, that's the grab attack, I think. And we saw how much damage that thing did before. Can we sneak up on this guy? What you think? I hope so. Yeah, boy, but I missed the backstab. I'm an idiot. Set it up perfectly and then failed. Oh well, oh well. Give me a chunk. Okay, twin bloodstone shards. I'll take them as well. I do like them a lot. And yeah, you enter this room here, which is basically, oh wow, almost the same as the other one. I will leave the ghosts alone. I can't really bother. The Executioner's Glove is an item that we can't use. It's similar to. Yeah, we have to lure this ghost a bit away. Then we can roll, get down, open the chest, and hopefully get through this before she attacks again. No, we can't, but okay then. The knight's attire, which does look absolutely great, if you ask me. I really love the look of it. But, yeah, for this character here, it's not what we want. Hopefully I didn't forget to open up the shortcut, or else. No, I think the shortcut. Yeah, it's here that you can open this. Okay. So this is the second shortcut. Basically, those Yeah, see, the ladder is now complete, and if you go outside there, we can return to the lamp, which we don't want right now. What we want to do is climb this ladder. And that's why I take out these blow dart guys or whatever there are on these two positions, because then they don't fire at us while we are moving up here. And we do get another chest. Let's see what we do receive here. Warm blood gemstone or gemstone, however you wanna pronounce that. Blood tinge scaling plus 13.5. So if you do use the Evelyn, here is a very good gemstone for you. Yeah, keep that in mind. When you're running through this area, just make a mental note to make sure you grab this item. I will just continue now. I think I didn't forget something that I need. So yeah, up ahead we do have some more of those guys. And I think there's even another one flying in from somewhere as soon as we cross the middle here. Or do we have to get a little bit... Yeah, and see the red glowing eyes there? That indicates this guy does not mess around at all. He's stronger than the enemies we fought so far. And... Ooh! Yeah, see? Almost died there. I do have about 30 vitality on this character, I think, so far. Which is good, otherwise I wouldn't be able to conquer this area. But yeah, and this is late game as well, guys. This is basically before the Night's Wick. Okay, this is basically before the boss fight with Mikolash, the Hoard of the Nightmare. That's right, that is the next boss that I will have to challenge. Nope. Not the next in the main game. But this optional area here has a boss that is very, very tricky indeed. He killed me quite some times when I first met him and first fought him even. And yeah, I don't have too much of good memories about that fight because it is tricky. And there we go, there's the visceral attack and it does one-shot them, so yeah. More Twin Bloodstone shards. Okay. The first time I was here, I didn't really know where to continue, but you just have to jump down. At this point, I mean, it's so obvious that you have to jump down and stuff, but when you're first crossing this area, you're so unsure if you should do that or not. And yeah, get some Kin Coldblood here, which will be useful for collecting the 40,000 souls that we need, but the boss fight is right up ahead. And I don't think... No, I don't have... I think bolt paper was the one thing that I used last time. And I should have some on me as well. Pretty sure. Yeah, I do have some on me. Perfect. So that's what we will use to buff our damage output. We do get some Bolt Hunter's Mark here, and I think it's very interesting that we do found them here, right before the boss. Yeah, it does somehow indicate, my words today, sorry guys. Yeah, it does indicate that something big is going on, and this is it. So, a little cutscene will start, and I will leave you with that, and shut up for a minute. Oh yes, Martyr Lagarius. It is a really hard boss fight, and you will... Oh, that's right, you can't actually That's the thing, the Blade of Mercy can't be enchanted. I totally forgot that. You can parry this guy, but this move there with the big skull will almost always hit you. Yeah. Even though with very good timing, it did hit me quite some time last time I fought him. Just because how the attack works, basically. There you go, there you can saw. Oh, there you can saw. Wow! English, please! There you saw it. He does have an attack where he summons swords, but I think that's in his second phase, if I'm not too mistaken. Basically, after one or two hits, just dash out of the way so you don't get hit by the Great Skull. And this attack there, that's an attack that you can parry. And sometimes you want to take this chance and parry him. Because as we know, parries do hit hard. You can dodge the Great Skull backwards, as you saw there. Which I didn't remember, actually, but yeah, the more you try, the more you know. And I don't like to be that close to the edge there, so I will try to lure him back here. Those skulls you can easily get rid of just by blocking the line of sight. You can hide behind these pillars, or yeah, just... I do have to close the distance, though. Oh, wow. I really have to. Or else he will screw me up big time! Oh wow. I healed up too much right now for my liking. Kind of... Oh, wow! Honestly, his attacks! Not that easy to read, and they hit very hard. Tried to use some regain there, but that was a completely dumb idea. Close the distance. Oh, wow, yeah, I think that's the AoE attack that he has, yes. Easy to dodge, you can sneak some free hits in there. There you can see the sword, and you want to get rid of the sword as soon as you possibly can, because the attack that follows will probably kill you if you don't get rid of the sword. And, yeah, that is an awesome opportunity if you can... Dodge the attack right, you get some good hits in there. But I screwed up. There we go, we want to get near again because we want to get rid of the sword. Get a hit in. And then dodge too late, apparently. Oh god, I'm so low on blood vials. I didn't dodge that. That was a bad play on my part that has nothing to do with his AI. That was just really, really bad dodging. As well as this. Oh my god, I will die here. Yeah, we will see us soon. Okay guys, we will try this again. And yes, I have made a little break now. Just 10 minutes or so. Just to calm my nerves and... that sounds like Morpheus now, but free my mind, I guess. Because once these guys get on your nerves, you make stupid mistakes. Like I just did there. I did it for a totally different reason, but I think you get what I mean, right? And yeah, we are not in a situation where we can allow us to make stupid mistakes, because I would have to farm blood vial after that if I want to continue. And that's not something that I really want to do now. Not because I do mind it too much, but I really want to get this episode out as soon as I can. And yeah, I'm getting... I'm struggling at the moment to keep up with the schedule that I would like to have. I'm not sure about you guys. I don't know how much you mind about when I'm missing a day or two in a week. Like I miss a Wednesday or a Sunday and not uploading then. I don't know, do you mind that too much, or are you okay with that? Because at the moment, I just can't play that often that I would like to. It's kind of different to explain. Nice parry there. But I don't know. I do struggle at the moment with not finding the motivation to put a video out. I do have that motivation, definitely. But I do struggle with getting the hang of playing a bit more. I don't know, I just at the moment I'm not too much. Whoops. Not too much into like gaming just for me. Yeah, I do play with some random guys or with friends in Counter-Strike or so, but just for one or two matches and then really I bail out again, and that's just something that does hit me from time to time. You know, when you just need a little bit of a break, I guess. Oh wow, I did get too close there. When you just need a little bit of a break, and I think it's not essentially a bad thing, you know. It's just, yeah, the time that this happens is a bit bad for me, anyways. Oh wow, I should have gone for the parry there, but a little bit of regain will help me out as well. That was completely unnecessary. Did get the parry here, but I can't follow it up. That's just unfortunate, but oh well. Sometimes, yeah. So, what do I have learned from playing this game and Dark Souls and generally hard games like that? The most important thing is your patience. Honestly, that's no joke. The amount that I died because of impatience is just unreal, guys. As I said, if something gets on your nerves, just make a break. You will get the. If you come back, you will perform better. That's just how it works. Second swing? No? The second swing is so much easier to parry. So I was really hoping that he will. No, don't get too close! Okay. Somehow he did flip me there. I tried to dodge, but. Oh yes, that was so important to get. That parry was, I think, the most important one so far. That really did put him down a bit. And is that enough to kill him? You know what? It actually is. Awesome! 50,000 souls. But echoes, excuse me. That should be enough, right? I really think that should be enough, and he should. Oh, the item is over there. And we will light this lamp, but we will not quite yet return to the Hunter stream. You might think, what the heck? I mean, there's nothing to do around here except for this item, but once we do pick that up and put it on our head, I really hope that doesn't give away stuff of my character. And if it does, well, then it is like that. We can't do anything, but let's see. Let's see. Should we take a look at the lore first of this item? I think so. Okay, one of the precious secrets of Kanehurst. The Old King's Crown is said to reveal illusions and expose a mirage that hides a secret. And so Logarius donned the crown of his own volition, determined to prevent a single soul from stumbling upon the vile secret. What visions did he see, sitting serenely upon his new throne? Well, what do you guys think? What did he see? Let's find out together, shall we? Oh yeah! Without the crown, he would not be able to see this and will not be able to enter this area. Yeah, so that's why you have to take this boss fight, and now we can enter. And yeah, the design of this stairway, I love it, man. I really do. I think it does look that awesome with the black and gold or gray, the pillars and the horses with the knights on it. Just oh, it does look so awesome. So now we are able to join the Covenant.
Visitor, moon-scented hunter, am Annalise, Queen of Castle Kanehurst. Ruler of the Vile Bloods, and sworn enemy of the Church. Yet, our people are murdered, and we are prisoner to this wretched mask. What is it thou art in search of?
We want to get... No, we want to become one of the Vile Bloods, so let's do that. Okay, we do get corruption, which I'm not too much interested in, but we did get the Kanehurst badge. That allows us, and respect, nice. Now, whenever we kill a hunter, we receive those special items that we can turn in here. And yeah, with the Kanehurst badge, we are able to buy the weapon that we need for this character, for this themed build. And yes, I'm so happy about that. I don't know if I will include the second area that we didn't visit so far, but for now, let's visit. Let's meet up in the Hunter Stream. Okay, guys, we are in the Hunter Stream, and you know what? Just for the sake of having it back, now we should be able to acquire the Chicago. There it is, 50,000 souls. A skill weapon and the only katana in Bloodborne. Yes, I do want that. I really do want that so bad, you can't even believe it. Let's equip this thing. Where is it? Wow, you need 30 skill to use it. No. Oh, that's right, we need 12 blood tinge to use it. Okay, but we do have it for now, which is a good thing. And yeah, let's check out the rune that we got, because I think it's one of those here. Yeah, corruption. Pretty nice, pretty nice. So if you're near death, this rune will constantly heal you, which I find is a pretty cool rune to have. And yeah, so I will have to farm up the what's it called? The Bloodstone shards and stuff to upgrade Chicago, gain some levels in Blood Tinge so I can level up to use it effectively. And yeah, then I guess in the next episode we will check out this new build and take on the third ending. So yeah, thank you very much for watching, guys, and as always, take care. Bye bye.